All right, hold on to your dentures, folks. In today's cartoon story joke, we're about to unleash a barrage of mother-in-law jokes that would make even the Sphinx groan. But hold your horses, or should I say, rocking chairs. Before we unleash this comedic avalanche, let's take a teeny tiny detour through history. It'll be quicker than your mother-in-law can guilt trip you into baking a pie, I promise. Let's start with the first oops, I married twice divorce. Back in the 1640s, divorce was about as common as finding a comfortable pair of jeans. You pretty much had to have a spouse with two heads, or maybe two wives like our guy in this story, to get a judge to break things off. This particular fellow, let's call him Henry, because that was a popular name back then, and because it sounds kind of stuffy, accidentally ended up married to two different women at the same time. Talk about a scheduling conflict. Let's just say his social calendar was a mess. Then there is the rise of the six-week vacation, divorce fast forward a few centuries, and people were itching to get out of unhappy marriages faster than a mime at a noisy party. Enter Reno, Nevada. Back then, Reno wasn't the glitzy Vegas we know today. It was more like a sleepy desert town with tumbleweeds and tumbleweeds of boredom. But then someone had a genius idea. Hey, why not make it super easy to get a divorce here? Thus began the era of the divorce ranch. These weren't your typical dude ranches with horses and lassos. These were all-inclusive resorts for folks who wanted to ditch their spouse faster than a bad toupee in a windstorm. You could relax by the pool, listen to lectures on the art of not so grieving your ex, and find yourself a new beau, or boo, as they probably called it back then, all within 6 short weeks. It was like a singles vacation, but with more lawyers and way fewer flamingos. Then there is the no fault here, except maybe my taste in partners. Divorce. Finally, in the groovy 1960s, things got a little less dramatic. Divorce laws loosened up, and people could finally split because they just weren't feeling the love anymore, not because someone forgot to take out the trash. Although, let's be honest, that's a pretty good reason too. This led to a boom in divorces, but also a sigh of relief from folks who were stuck in marriages about as exciting as watching paint dry. Next, there is the DIY divorce because lawyers cost more than my wedding ring era. And then came the internet. Now you could download divorce forms faster than you could say irreconcilable differences. No more fancy lawyers with their big fees. People could become their own divorce DJs, spinning the tunes of freedom at a fraction of the cost. So, that's the history of divorce in a nutshell, or maybe a pistachio shell because that's a funny image. It's a story of changing times, loosening laws, and the ever-present human desire to find happiness, even if it means saying I don't twice or more. All right, enough with the sad trombone sound effects. We all know Liam's love life is a dumpster fire right now, but who needs a downer on a Friday night? Let's skip the pity party and fast forward to the good stuff, the laugh-a-minute portion of the evening. Buckle up, folks, because the joke, and the reason for Liam's misery, all boils down to one legendary figure, Mildred, Brenda's mother. It was a Friday night, and the air crackled with the sweet scent of freedom. Or maybe that was just Liam's overflowing ashtray. Our man Liam looked like he'd been tangoed with by a particularly aggressive cactus. He slumped into his favorite armchair with a sigh that could deflate a blimp, narrowly missing a half-eaten bag of Funyuns. Across from him sat Rick, his best friend since they were both convinced they could fly by jumping off the roof with bedsheets. Spoiler alert, they couldn't. Rick, ever the optimist, raised an eyebrow.
Rough day, mate? Still dealing with the whole Brenda situation?
Dealing? Rick, this isn't dealing with a flat tire. This is a full-on marital meltdown, a Category 5 hurricane of emotions.
Spill the beans, Liam. Did Brenda find your hidden stash of vintage Star Wars action figures again? You know how possessive she gets about Chewbacca.
Far worse, Rick. Far worse. It's her mother, Mildred.
Ah, Mildred. The woman who could make Mother Teresa question her faith in humanity. Brenda's a lovely lass, but her mom, well, let's just say Attila the Hun had better table manners.
You don't understand, Rick. The woman could turn sunshine into a guilt trip faster than you can say passive-aggressive casserole. Every visit was an emotional obstacle course. Liam, she'd coo, those jeans seem a tad snug around the midsection. Or, Brenda darling, have you considered a color palette that doesn't clash with your complexion?
Sounds rough, buddy, but hold on, why blame Mildred for the divorce?
Liam leans in, eyes gleaming like a mischievous chipmunk who just discovered a forgotten bag of Funyuns.
Now listen here, Rick. When a relationship goes south, don't just blame the wife. It takes two to tango, you see? Blame her mom as well.
If you liked our joke, then please watch our next joke by clicking here.